So in this slide, we'll be discussing about not for profit. See, so what is a not for profit? See, not for profit organizations, for them, the primary goal is not to make profits. Okay, it's not, you can't measure them through economic measures. So if you can't measure them through profit or maximization of wealth or share price, then it becomes very difficult to find out how they perform. So NFP organizations have the following characteristics. Most do not have an external stakeholder. There are no shareholders as such. And hence, maximization of shareholder wealth is not the primary objective. There are no shareholders. Then what is the primary objective? So no profit maximization, no shareholder maximization. There is no need to distribute dividends. So financial management is concerned about financing element, investing element, and dividend element. There's no dividend at all in NFP organizations. Their objectives are usually some kind of a social, cultural, philanthropic kind of a activity. Hence, there is no profit element to measure at all in NFPs. When assessing the performance of NFP, it is important to include both financial and non-financial measures. So we can't have profit alone to be measured. We have to also measure some other non-financial measures. So that's where the difficulty arises. So what are the problems in financial management of an NFP? One, we cannot quantify the cost and benefit. For example, if you're running an hospital, you can't quantify the benefit of treating a patient having a cold and the patient having an open heart surgery. That benefit cannot be like measured very equally. That is very tough. And sometimes costs cannot be measured properly. For example, having police force is a cost. So can we cut down the police force? That is a cost. We can have cut down the cost by reducing the number of police employees in police force, but that would have repercussions in the number of crimes increasing. So there is a problem in quantifying the cost and benefit. Assessing the use of funds, which is the optimum utilization of the fund? Assume that in the case of police department, should the money be spent on giving more salary to the police, give more salary, or install more cameras? Which has to be done? If you do this, the employees are motivated. If you do this, the crime gets reduced. Which one you have to do? That again cannot be measured because there's no ROCE as such, because motivation is non-financial. Installing cameras, it's partly financial, but the benefit it offers is non-financial. There are multiple and diverse objectives. So for police, it's about preventing crimes, ensuring safety, and building confidence among the people. So they have multiple objectives. So it's very difficult to trade one thing with another. The impact of politics on performance measurement, what has to be measured? Okay, so that again is a problem. So there are multiple problems in NFPs. So the best way to deal with this is value for money concept. So value for money concept is often quoted as an objective in NFP organizations. That is, have they gained the best value from the limited funds? Okay, again, the word value is subjective still, but we only have VFM as the closest measurement technique for NFPs. So we use three E's. The first E is economy. So assume that we'll take a hospital. Economy is, we want to construct a hospital. Are we doing it at the lowest cost possible, but at the reasonable quality, cheapest possible, at the quality desired? So is the hospital of good quality and done at a lowest price? That is called as economy. Efficiency, here we link the input and outputs. Is the maximum output being achieved from the resource? So assume the hospital has been built to treat 100 patients. Okay, are we doing it? If you are treating 90 people, then it's 90% efficiency. If you are treating 120 people, it's like 120% efficiency. So we link between the with the construction of hospital, how many people we are trying to treat. And the last one is effectiveness. Effectiveness looks at not at the number of people being treated, but whether the hospital has finally achieved its objective. What is its ultimate objective? To reduce the total number of infections and patients in that area, and to increase their happiness of using the hospital service. So that's what is called as effectiveness. So NFPs can be measured in the following ways. So you can read it for yourself. All these NFPs are created for a university or a college, so you can read it by your own. We have this question: which of the following statements are correct? You can read it. Share option schemes always reward good performance by managers. The answer is no, it cannot always do it, because sometimes the share price can go lower. So this is not the right one. Performance related pay can encourage dysfunctional behavior. Yes. Value for money as an objective is in not-for-profit organizations requires the pursuit of economy, efficiency and effectiveness. The answer is yes. So 2 and 3 are correct. 3, 2 and 3 comes under C. Okay. So share option schemes always reward good payment performances. No, they don't always do it, because sometimes even when you give share options, people can cheat and the share price can go up or low, and it might not reward their performance properly. So that was the disadvantage there. So that's about this question.